Thanksgiving may be around the corner, but turkey isn't the only bird you should be looking forward to this month. Hello everyone, Sober Oni of G&A Reviews here, with a servant spotlight for the caster who is sure to make you pick up bird watching as your hobby, Caster of Okeanos. We'll be examining her stats and skills, as well as going over pointers and how to utilize her effectively, and an overall grade, comparing her to how she stacks up to the other 4-star servants. Now, on to caster stats. Caster has a max HP of 12,250 and a max attack of 8,671, which becomes 7,803 due to her caster class modifier. Caster of Okeanos has both very good HP and attack for a 4-star caster. Unfortunately though, her attack is still very low compared to all the other 4-star servants, although she does retain a very high HP stat. Overall, she has really good stats for a caster, both offensively and defensively, but even the strongest caster is massively outclassed by most other servants, so her stat spread still favors defense. Taking a look at her skills, her first skill is Rapid Divine Words, rank B. It increases her NP gauge between 60 and 120%, depending on level. Her second skill is Poisoned Meal, rank A. It inflicts poison on all enemies, dealing between 500 and 1000 damage per turn for 3 turns. It also decreases their defense for 3 turns, between 10 and 20%, both depending on level. And finally, her last skill is Advice for Sailing, rank A. It increases the crit star drop rate of all allies for 3 turns, between 30 and 50%, depending on level, and it also removes all debuffs. For passives, she has Territory Creation rank B, which increases her Archcard effectiveness by 8%, and Item Construction rank A, which increases her debuff success rate by 10%. As for her deck and Noble Phantasm, Caster has an Arts deck with Quick Arts 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 Buster and a Buster Noble Phantasm. Her Noble Phantasm Metabo Piglets deal significant damage to a single enemy with between a 600 and 1000% damage modifier depending on level. It also inflicts the Pig stun status against one enemy for one turn and decreases their critical hit rate for 3 turns between 10 and 50% depending on overcharge. Taking a closer look at her cards, we see that her quick card hits 3 times, her arts hits 3 times, her buster hits twice, and her extra attack hits 4 times. She has an NP gain rate of 0.39% and a star rate of 10.8%. This is some very bad NP gain despite the triple arts deck due to that obscenely low NP gain rate and only 3 hits per arts. She also has poor star generating from just one quick card and low hit counts. Caster of Okeanos is a uniquely strange servant that has her fingers in a lot of different cookie jars all at once. Her stats are really good for a caster, having both above average HP and attack. However, she is noticeably lacking in NP gain and star gen, which is especially weird given her triple arts card deck. In fact, she has some of the lowest NP gain of any of the caster servants. Things do look up for Caster of Okeanos when we get to her skills though. Rapid Divine Words is a tremendous NP charging skill that effectively gives you an instant free Noble Phantasm. This skill works very similar to Media's version, albeit a bit weaker, in that it allows Caster of Okeanos to Noble Phantasm twice on back-to-back turns, whether you need it for damage or utility, making it highly versatile. And it goes a long way toward making up for her lack of NP gain. Caster's second skill, Poisoned Meal, is another good skill that inflicts poison on all enemies and decreases their defense. Another way to look at this skill is like a Charisma that also inflicts poison. Just like with Charisma, the short cooldown and strong defense debuff allow your entire team to deal much better damage for most of the fight. But keep in mind that debuffs can be avoided and resisted by enemies, so this skill isn't quite as consistent as Charisma. However, the extra poison effect does have nice synergy with some servants. Finally, Advice for Sailing allows Caster to cleanse all debuffs from the party and also has a star gen buff. AoE debuff removal is clutch for tougher content, and it makes Caster of Okeanos very good in long battles where sometimes debuffs can be an issue. The star generating buff is also very nice. It's like a mini version of Caster Gil's star gen buff, and it allows Caster of Okeanos to be a solid pick in arts crit teams despite having her own lack of star gen. Skill priority should be Rapid Divine Words first, make sure you get that at least to level 8 so that you have your free NP, followed by Poisoned Meal for better DPS and team utility, and then Advice for Sailing last because debuff removal is more niche. Caster of Okeanos' Noble Phantasm is possibly her greatest asset. It is a single target buster NP that decreases enemy crit rate and turns them into a pig for a turn. Being turned into a pig is effectively just a stun, but it looks cool as hell. Even though this is a single target Buster Noble Phantasm, don't expect much damage, as Caster of Okeanos doesn't have an NP interlude, and she doesn't really have any damage buffs either. Instead, the main purpose of this Noble Phantasm is the stun. It'll land on most enemies, and because Caster can NP on back-to-back turns with Rapid Divine Words, she basically has a free 2-turn stun on command, which is huge, especially for stall teams. It also makes Caster a great switch-in option with Battlesuit, as between her and that Mystic Code, you'll have 2 or 3 stuns. As you can imagine, between the special stuns, party buffs, and enemy debuffs, Caster of Okeanos can best be classified as a high-utility, semi-support servant. She can provide an arts team with excellent stalling, star generating, better damage, and debuff removal. This makes her flexible and useful for a wide range of situations, whether it be challenge quests or crit support. But unfortunately, this mishmash of support skills isn't as cohesive as you would think. Caster of Okeanos' primary weakness is that she tries to perform too many roles and falls flat in most of them. For example, her star gen buff is good, but not enough to sustain an arts crit team on its own, especially given her own poor star generating. And the defense debuff is good for general party support, but it does fall short of what other supports offer, and in most cases a standard charisma is just better. This lack of sufficient support is made worse by giving her a single target Buster NP, which really doesn't synergize with her kit at all, and it stifles her ability to Noble Phantasm as often as she needs to. In the end, a lot of what Caster of Okeanos offers is just not enough, and you're better off using any other specialized support to fit your needs. The one unique thing that Caster does offer is her special stun, which to her credit can be life-saving. But even that won't work on every enemy. There are some special boss servants and challenge quest enemies that are immune to her stun. But all hope is not lost. Caster of Okeanos can work well given the right teammates. You want to use Caster primarily on an arts team as either a staller with her NP stun and debuff clear, or as a general crit support who can bolster party damage and star gen with her second and third skills. If you're using her in an art stall team, I highly recommend pairing her with Uriel, Tamamo, or Bibi. Against male enemies, Caster and Uriel can near permanently deny an enemy from NPing, given how many stuns, charms, and NP drains they have in their kits. Tamamo also works well providing healing, NP drain, and much needed NP charge and cooldown reduction for Caster, so that she can potentially NP spam. Bibi also provides good NP charge and additional debuff removal if you're up against an enemy that spams debuffs. On the other end of the spectrum, you can use arts attackers like Robin Hood or Saber Lancelot with Caster as well. Robin Hood benefits a lot from the additional poison that Caster inflicts, and as an archer, he can use his high natural star weight to absorb the bonus stars the team produces from Caster's skill. Likewise, Saberlot appreciates the extra stars, as well as the added defensive support from the cleanse and stun. Caster of Okeanos' Bondcraft Essence is Banquet of the Falcon Witch. It boosts the party NP gain and NP damage by 10%. This is okay if you're playing a support role for offensive servants, but whether you're supporting or stalling, you're usually far better off using craft essences that give more utility either through star generating or NP gain, like 2030, Fox Knight's Dream, Prisma Cosmos, or Magical Girl of Sapphire. In the future, you can also equip Caster with Annual General Meeting, as it buffs arts and NP gain while also generating crit stars every turn, so it's ideal for her. Overall, Caster of Okeanos can be really underwhelming. None of her skills provide really strong or unique buffs. Despite having an offensive NP, her damage is non-existent. She doesn't have or provide any hard defense, and generally speaking, there are many lower rarity supports who do a better job of providing star gen and damage buffs. But Caster does have the benefit of being flexible and able to wear many hats, so she can fit into many different arts teams. And because of her NP, she has tremendous potential in stall teams. So she does get a C from me. Caster of Okeanos is usable in many arts teams as a complementary support if you're going for a 2-support, 1-DPS build. But don't expect her to do any of the heavy lifting, and a lot of the time she does just boil down to being an extra stun button on your battle suit. And those are my thoughts on Castor of Okeanos, another well-designed and adorable servant who sadly does not live up to the competition in terms of gameplay. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you haven't already, do check out the other EOR4 servant spotlights I've done for Abigail, Neja, and Castor of Midrash, linked both on screen and in the description. Also, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like and consider subscribing if you really enjoyed the video. Join the party over at our Discord, chill with us on Twitch, and follow us on Twitter. And I'll see you all in the next servant spotlight. Soberoni out. Later.